Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Nadia and I study in China, and sometimes I talk about this amazing and a little bit controversial country. Do you want to know how the people have fun and spend their leisure time in China? Then continue to watch this video. Karaoke or KTV, as it's called in China, is by far the most popular place to hang out with friends here in China. You can come with your friends and you will get your own private room where you can order some food, snacks, drinks, and even some girls, kind of Japanese geisha. The Chinese like to play cards and mahjong. You can often see group of people sitting and enthusiastically dealing cards. You can see those players in parks. They're used to it because some time ago it's easy forbidden to women to work or leave the house without men. We're both sitting at home and started to play mahjong with other do-nothing women. Eating hot pot is a very popular pastime of the Chinese, especially in the colder season. But they're perfectly fine in the summer as well. Any reason for celebration, someone passed an exam, receiving monthly salary, really anything can be celebrated at the hot pot table. It consists of a boiling pot of the broth installed in the middle of the table. The broth can be full of chili or not, depends on your taste, because you're going to cook whole your dinner inside this. You can cook anything really, from thinly sliced beef and sea cucumbers to potatoes and veggies. Goose blood, pork brains, and beef intestines are considered as really delicious as here. They like jogging, taichi, playing badminton, or to do some other sport. I really want to be a Chinese grandma when I'm old. I want to be full of energy, active, and sort of an example for the young generation. Chinese saunas are completely different with European ones. They are really huge and look a bit more like hotels. In these saunas, you will find at least two floors. The first floor is for separated between female and male bathhouses. They are saunas, bath with different temperatures. On the second floor, you will find dry heat bath, cinemas, gyms, restaurants and cafes, beauty saloons with manicure, pedicure and massages. You can find even computers with video games here. Such a paradise! You can even spend a night there as well. You will find electric sockers, power banks for loan for 1 kwai per hour, super comfortable reclining seats for sleeping. Basically everything you need to relax. Here is a small life hack for you. If you want to spend a night there in China, but you don't want to spend a lot of time on staying in a hotel, stay in the sauna then. It's really cheap and convenient. Here, hotels cost around 200-300 kwai for a night, and a night at the sauna cost only 70 kwai. Chinese people love massages. The most famous one is blind people massage. They're specially told by schools of Chinese medicine. Once I came to a Chinese company and a VIP party, and the boss treated everyone, including me, to a group foot massage. That's how it's done. There are some of the most interesting ways to spend your leisure time in China. What do people in your country do to have fun? Do you have something interesting to share with us? Put in the comments below. Oh, thank you guys. Thank you very much for watching my videos. Give me a like if you like the video, and subscribe to my channel if you would like to see more of them. See you!